Hello everyone, welcome back to Tech Wizards. And today we will learn about a kind of neural network using which we will be able to remove noise from the image. As we can see in this image, we will supply noisy input to our model and it will generate a clean denoised image. So how do we do that? To do that, we make use of a special kind of neural network known as an autoencoder. It is based on an unsupervised learning strategy as we do not provide our model with any labeled dataset. An encoder consists of three components, that is, an encoder, code, and a decoder. The function of encoder is to compress the input and produce the code. The decoder then reconstructs the image only using this code. So we can think of it as a compression decompression algorithm, where encoder compresses the given input and the decoder decompresses the given input. These kinds of neural networks are very useful in reducing the dimension of the given input. If my input is of very high dimension, then this network can encode the input into a very less dimensional space. These networks are often used with other neural networks like the recurrent neural networks, where it is used for text translation from any one language to other language, like English to French or vice versa. Such neural networks can also convert code written in one programming language to another. We can either use a fully connected layer in both encoder and decoder, as shown in the figure, where each node is connected to every node present. So here each node is present to the other node. And at each node, what happens is we multiply the input with the weight value and we add a bias value, and all this is passed through an activation function. Or we can use a convolutional encoder-decoder architecture, where we use a convolutional neural network at encoder and a deconvolutional neural network at decoder. To understand better how convolutional neural networks work, you can check out my other video that is about deep convolutional general adversarial networks. There I have talked in depth about how convolutional neural networks work. Talking about the loss function, in such network, we either use mean squared error or binary cross entropy loss function to calculate the loss between the output given by the decoder and input given to the encoder. And once loss is calculated, we use back propagation to update our weights throughout the network. Now let's have a look at the different types of autoencoders that we have. We have fully connected autoencoder, fully connected deep autoencoder, where we add multiple layers, so it becomes a deep network. We have a sparse autoencoder, convolutional autoencoder, denoising autoencoder that we will be creating today, and a variational autoencoder. So now let's have a look at a denoising autoencoder. In denoising autoencoder, we train our model to reduce the loss between output from decoder and the original noise-free image rather than the noisy image. And once properly trained, our model removes noise from all the images given to it. But such kind of networks have a limitation. That is, it won't work properly on those inputs on which it is not trained. So it can only remove noise from those images on which it is trained. We can also use this kind of architecture in neural inpainting, where we crop a small portion of the image and we force our neural network model to regenerate the cropped portion of the image as it has done over here. So now let's have a look at the code. First of all, we will import all our necessary dependencies. This here creates a directory, that is MLP directory. And we have defined a function that is toImage, which actually returns the image. It helps us in viewing the image. Then we have defined our three hyperparameters, that is number of epochs or number of our iterations for which we want our model to train. Here we have taken it as 20, then batch size and 128 and learning rate. And we have also defined one more method, that is addNoise method, which takes normal input, which takes normal image as an input and adds noise to it. And how is it doing? It just adds random values to our already existing image and it returns noise image. Then this function, that is the plot sample image, it takes image and name as its arguments and just save that image in the PNG format. And these two methods, that is the min-max normalization and the tensor round, are used for the normalizing process of the image. Then we have used the transform.compose method of the PyTorch to convert it into tensor and then normalizing the image. Then we have used the MNIST dataset as we will be training our model on MNIST dataset. And then we have passed all this information to our data loader. After that, we have defined a class, that is autoencoder class, which is inheriting the neural network. And we have defined the architecture for both the encoder and the decoder over here. Inside the encoder, first of all, it will take a 28 by 28 image as an input, and it will try to reduce it to 256. Then we have used a rectifier linear unit as our activation function. Then again, we have added one more layer, which will take 256 as an input and will return 64 as output. Then again, we have used ReLU as an activation function. Then inside the decoder, what we have done is, it will take 64 as an input and it will return 256. So it is now upsampling the image. Then we have used a ReLU, then we have added one more layer, and at the end it's going to give us 28 by 28. So we can see the input and the output are of the same size, that is 28 cross 28. And at the end we have used as sigmoid as our activation function. And inside our forward function, we have defined how our network will progress. Then we have created an object for our autoencoder class, and we have also used CUDA function with it. CUDA function is mainly used so that if we are having GPU, that is NVIDIA GPU, it's going to use that to train our model a bit faster. Then we have also defined our loss function. Here we are using the binary cross entropy loss function and our Adam optimizer. Then inside the loop, it's going to run for 20 iterations. And for each iteration, it's going to look at the data which is present in the data loader, and it's going to first of all store it inside the image. And what it's going to do is, it's going to add noise to that image and it will store it into the noisy image. And once that is done, we're going to pass the noisy image to our model. And after that, we will pass it to the criteria, or our criteria is our binary cross entropy loss. So we'll pass it both the output and our image to our loss function. And once that is done, we will use the optimizer to optimize our weight values. So for every 10th iteration, it's going to print the output. So what is happening for epoch modulus 10 equals to equal to 0 means for every 10th iteration, it's going to save our image in the PNG format. Our three kinds of images, that is a normal image, x hat and x noise image. And after that, we have saved the state of the model. So now let's see what happens when we try to run it. And it's going to take a bit. It's going to take some time. So as you can see, for the first iteration, our loss value is this, and it's going to reduce our loss. For it's going to go for 20 iteration, it's going to do the same thing, and our loss value will be reduced. As I've already trained my model, I can show you the output. This here, it will be our noise free image. As you can see, it's totally clean, and it actually began from here. The noisy image will look like something this. This here is a complete noisy image. As you can see, it's going to remove all the noise from the image and it's going to give us the noise free image. So yes, that's it from my side. And the GitHub link for this code will be down in the description. And if you like my videos, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thank you very much.